Hey, it's Fran, again, in the lab, having some fun with something new. This is a really cool little setup I got going today on the bench. This is an IEEE one-plane readout, which is a name that kind of really doesn't make any sense, certainly doesn't let you know what it is, but these were, I guess, pretty popular in the 50s, 60s, maybe 70s for digital displays. And it's completely incandescent. There's an arrangement of 10 little individual incandescent bulbs. Each of them have their own lens assembly, and it projects light through an aperture and through a tiny piece of film, and projects a number on a screen, which for this setup I'm actually using a little frosted glass slide, a little lab slide, just as a reproduction screen. But if I slide the slide away, and each of those little individual projectors firing off. So these little displays are made by IEEE, which stands for Industrial Electronic Engineers Incorporated. And on the IEEE website, it says that they started making these displays in 1956. Not really sure when they stopped making them, but just in researching various types of these displays that they made, I've seen some with date codes going into the early 90s, so they've made them for quite a while. The ones I have here are date coded in 1984, new old stock, so I'm sure that they were making these as replacement displays for quite some time. As you can see, it's got a very long throw. The depth of field is pretty deep, so you can have it project quite a ways out. Unfortunately, because the guns are aligned to be more or less right at the display, if you pull it out, you can see that the alignment gets off and the numbers just sort of... Also, it seems in this display, it looks like the 8 is actually upside down. I don't know. Looks like the small circle of the 8 is actually on the bottom side. I don't know. Yeah, I think that 8 is upside down. And also the 9 is just a 6 that's upside down. Looks like they took some hints from Nixie tubes on that one. I just think this is so much potential for these displays. You know, putting a colored gel behind the little projector screen to change the color, even maybe some kind of mechanical thing to change the zoom, I don't know. I'm thinking of all kinds of things I could do with this. I really love these displays. I don't have a socket for these displays, but the little incandescent bulbs, fortunately they have a tiny little solder blob on the back that would contact a socket point, but I just soldered wires directly to the bulbs, and there's also a common, which I've just made a common anode pin, which I also soldered to. A little tedious, but it does work. It's kind of cool to see the little bulbs firing off from the side there. You can see them firing off in there, yeah. And this particular display takes max 14 volts. I'm around 13. I didn't really want to run it too hot because I want these little lamps to last a little longer than I guess they would normally. But they will work. I've run them down as little as like 8 volts or so, and they're still fairly readable. So they have a fairly wide voltage range. Although I don't want to go over voltage on these again, you know, with the incandescence, you'll get a lot more hours out of them if you run them under voltage, certainly. So I've been thinking about what to do with these displays. I got a whole set of them. thinking that they'd probably make a nice clock. I guess that would be the natural choice for a project, but it definitely would be a current-hungry clock, that's for sure, and it would sure generate a lot of heat because this display, just running it, I mean, it does get warm. So let's take a look at the setup I have here. On these clip leads, I've got a 13-volt DC from my bench supply, and here I've got a little regulated 5-volt supply that is powering the counter board. I've got a 555 timer running a 4017 decade counter, and the output of that is going through this header to this board I made yesterday, which is just a driver board. It's got 10 transistors that are switching the 5-volt output from the 4017 and stepping it up to switch the 13-volt supply to drive the display. You might have, if people who saw my diode steering video that I did a while back remember that little 4017 board that I used also to drive the diode steering 7-segment display that I did a little while back. It was very handy, and I've just converted it to drive this little display. You enjoyed this short little video. I'd like to develop this into a bigger project, certainly. I really like these rear projection displays. Might try to get some larger ones too, because these are the smallest ones that they made, but they did make ones that were quite large, and the larger ones are kind of easy to modify with your own custom stencils, and if you want to put your own film in there. These displays, I mean, those it's like microfilm for these little displays. I think that the actual numbers in there, they're probably like a millimeter tall, almost microscopic. You definitely need a magnifying glass to see them. So these really wouldn't be practical to try to modify. But the larger ones, people have hacked them. I've seen people make up their own displays for the ones with the larger masks in them. So but anyway, thanks to the members of Team Fran Lab for sponsoring me on Patreon. In fact, I got a new thing going on right now for a pre-order page on my website for the Team Fran Lab t-shirt. And if you get a t-shirt, become a member of Team Fran Lab, one-time donation to the lab, you get a shirt. This is a sort of a pre-order campaign because these shirts are going to be made to order. So you pick the style, pick the size, pick the color that you want. We're going to do a 3-week campaign, and after everyone puts in their orders, we go and we have all the shirts made. You get your shirt. It's kind of the practical way to do it because we're doing them right here in Philly. So yeah, it's a chance for you to support Fran Lab and get a cool shirt custom made. These are custom made to order. So sponsor the lab, get a shirt. Win-win. All right. Well, that's it. I'm Fran, and I'll be back in the lab pretty soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.